Hello, my name is Scott for SB Gaming. Welcome back to Betrayer. We are here in the outlying settlement, and in the previous two episodes, we explored the area. In the two episodes before, we gathered most of the clues, most of the stuff here. We gathered most of it, ended here, and then continued rest. Secured this little outpost here, and then went into the other world and found the Wraith, and the Wraith and the Shadow. Found out what had happened here. So it's time to move on. Fort Hope. Actually, before we do, I just looked at my health. Yeah, I might want to fill up. And where's the barrel of water? Right here. All right, now we're good. Although I'm kind of short on arrows. Nah, it should be good. We should be fine. All right. So, where are we right now? Ooh, we're right down here. And we have a lot of stuff in here. These are the totems, I think. Yep. We have chests there. We have notes there. We have clues there. We have two Wraiths. We have three shadows and a couple graves. All right, and so I'm going to head off in this direction. Those are the loons I was referring to. All right. Off in that direction. So what is going on here? Do I see the... So we have a chest here and 35 coins. And what do we got here? Page scrap. The prisoner, a most Christian sort, was overcome with tears and spoke of partaking in the massacre of men, women, and children at a French colony they found far north of here. Right there. That's one of those creatures. And there's a item there. All right, well, on the one hand, they'll be easy to spot. Oh, wow. Whoa! And I am out of arrows. Common shortbow. Weathered shortbow broken. Alright, well, we got 10 arrows. Yeah, there was a couple of them there. Yeah, with this mist or whatever this is, they are a lot easier to spot. Which I would say is a nice gift, because they... If they were over there, they would be hard to spot. Yeah, in there. You have to really pick them out from the darkness and the light. Richard Prodger, killed by savages. Alright, so I'm going to... Yep, go in this direction. Right there. I think there's two of them. Clue. Dug up a brown leather rapier scabbard with intricate silver buckles and fittings. The shape that protected its tip is missing. A great quantity of blood seeped into the soil here. So yeah, there is likely a wraith. Nope, there's a shadow here. All right, I'd like to head south. Which is... that direction. There's one right there. Oh. Alright, about this. I think there's like four of them there. Alright, well, we have 12 arrows. And we have a barrel of water. Today I heard a story about a vain woman who fancied herself beautiful above all women. She coveted jewelry and trinkets to make herself more desirable when she preened and posed. Many young men wooed her, but she was only interested in the affections of the strongest, most prosperous suitors. One day she overheard a group of old crones talking about three brothers who lived alone in the deep forest. They were fearless hunters and mighty warriors, and said to be handsome above all men. The woman demanded to know where she might find these brothers, but the crones told her she should stay far away from them, for they were as cruel and vicious as they were cunning and capable. But she insisted on knowing, and was quickly on her way to find the brothers. She was still walking when darkness fell, but soon she saw a fire ahead and made her way to it. Sure enough, around it sat three of the finest men she had ever beheld. She walked forward into the firelight to announce herself, but the brothers fell upon her at once, ravishing her like the beast they were, so that her screams carried through the forest. She woke early the following morning in terrible pain, bloody and bruised and stripped of pride. The brothers lay sprawled upon the grass in deep and carefree slumber, so she took up an axe and hacked off their heads one by one. She returned to the crones who had told her of the brothers and hacked them to death, then wandered through the village hacking apart everyone she met until finally several hunters managed to drag her down. So powerful was her anger that they could barely restrain her, so one of them grabbed up the axe and struck off her head. Still, she seethed and raged with such ferocity that there was no choice but to cut off her limbs, but still the parts of her writhed with murderous intent. Finally, they dug a great hole. Inside the hole, they built a great fire. They cast all the pieces of her into the flames, but when they saw that they wouldn't burn, they covered over the hole with soil and heavy stones and placed powerful charms in a circle around it to warn all who passed near. It is said that if you go to where she lives, you can feel the earth tremble with her rage. Huh. All right. Drink. And longbow arrow. Nothing in that one. And explosive. Alright. So we are here. There is a totem just around here. Oh, that's right. It's probably going to only show up at night. Or in the other world. That tends to happen. Alright, so there's some stuff over in this direction. Where are they? Right over there. Probably behind those rocks. Yeah, they could be in there and I would not even see them. Huh. Yep. Right there. To use my quality musket. And there's a clue, but we unfortunately need a shovel. Alright, so there is something else over here. This grave appears to have been dug up and filled back in. The name on the marker is illegible. A digging spade well suited for breaking through hard soil. You can now dig in places where the trowel wasn't suitable. Nice! Collected a spade. Dug up a small key. Alright, now I can go back to all those places, which I might do in a cleanup episode, just because reasons. Alright, so north-northwest, roughly that direction. All right. That is awesome. We come across the shovel. Chest is empty. And 35 coins. All right, we are going to continue heading north. See it over there, and there is something. Right there. Go. And what do we got here? Page crap. Amunti says the neighboring tribes have heard of the sickness that has beset her people, have become greedy for their territory. Lately, they have had to repel raiding parties sent to test their strength. Her father seeks a treaty with us, by which each will protect the other. Here's the one I killed. Ooh. All right, about that. Anyway, you got some more longbow arrows. And now, so this is Fort Hope right there. If we take a look at it on our map, so we are down here. All right. Now, yep, we're going to want to head north. Yeah, those creatures blend in. Wonder if we're going to come across the conquistadors here. Or if this is just an area with the creatures. Oh! Drink! Oh! And that was a weird creature. Not seen that before. That looked like a spider. Well, about that. So that was right around here. Anyway, yeah, it ripped me to pieces. So I'm going to head off in this direction. Since I have nothing else to explore here, we're going to come around like that. Well, that was rather unfortunate. On the one hand, anything we do discover, we hang on to. Oh, there he is. I think the game auto-saves after every item you collect, which is nice and convenient. You don't need to... Oh, wow. You have... Far to go. Just gonna run. And I was spotted. All right. Are we being chased? Not that I can see. And examine. The cart seems to have become stuck in the mud. The remains of a woman who appears to be bound to the tree. There are signs that she was savaged by wild beasts, though whether she was alive or dead by then is unclear. Dug up a silver locket with a broken chain. It contains an image of the Savior. The initials PM are inscribed on the back. One there, there's one there. Oh! Bother. Alright. Yeah, I'm going to want to keep going to the north. Alright, so I see one there. Nice. Three of them. Common short pole broken. And we have a totem. It is shrouded in corruption. So what we are going to need to do when we get to the overworld or the other world, we're going to have to come back here, fight some creatures, and release the corruption. All right, there's a chest right there. And now we might as well head west to the fort. Is this up on a hill? And Nicholas Tucker rests here. Journal updated. And we found the bell. So there's something over here. $46. And another figure in ash. Oh, that's right. Oh, wow. All right. Nice. Unlocked Fort Hope destination. Let's drink some more. All right. So I'm guessing this place got attacked. A noose hangs from the crossbeam. It is no heathen curse that afflicts us. It is punishment from God. For we parley with his enemies when we should strike them down. We must not fear them, even if every last savage rises against us, for God is with us. All right. And 200 coins. All right. I am hunted and haunted in equal measure. I have sustained wounds and bruises to my body and my pride. Yet still I have managed to secure several items of fine quality. I hope they are of interest, as you seem to be my last customer. Quality crossbow. 900. Interesting. Exceptional musket. Yeah. So 115 damage. Exceptional pistol. You know what? I'm going to buy the exceptional musket. And then inventory. We have a lot of weathered short bows. Common short bow. All right, so I'm going to sell one of those. Sell price, yeah, 3.5. Exceptional musket, we are going to put in there. And the quality musket, we're going to sell. Quality charm of ferocity. Common short bow, crude pistol. And quality short bow. Oh. Where did I get that? Must have got it either last episode or earlier on. Very fast. Versus fast. It's 35 damage. Meh. 120 damage. 115 damage. Special is a stagger. Speed slow. Yep. Range very short. Range moderate. Yeah, that's the... If we take a look at the clues, the bell, recovered a bell at Fort Hope, cart, digging spade, dug up grave, noose, so there's probably something still about that, silver locket, small key, victim has been mauled, And there is a story behind all this. People. Benedict Harper failed to return from an expedition. Oh, never mind. Graves and notes. All right. We have a chest here worth 34 coins. All right, so we have let's replace the bell. All right, let's read. When you would not grant him audience, Griffin May traveled to my home to accost me with his usual litany of complaints. Delivered with his usual wearisome fervor, it was all I could do to send him on his way before dark, lest he think to impose upon my hospitality for the night. All right, so there's one more item over here. Oh, I missed this. Dug up an ornamental silver shape for a rapier scabbard. So that must have been all clues found. Alright, there is some items over here. I'm suspecting that is the only entrance. Nope. Okay, never mind. Alright, so there's something else over here. Oh! I suspect the missing bell was taken by Morris Abbott, for he has often complained that its pealing unsettles the creatures of the forest and keeps them from his snares, though it is more likely that reeking pipe he insists on smoking. Can it be chance that the bell vanished the very morning he left with Icarus supplies to return to his cabin in the woods? Be wary that he doesn't try to steal the other bell upon his next visit. All right. Now I want to head over in that direction. There are a few more items over on this side of the fort. And we have a grave. Roland Graves, killed by savages. All graves found. And there's something over here. The captain said that Allison Markley started screaming, then fainted dead away. When they finally roused her, she began to sob, saying her sister was dead. Markley. Name sounds familiar. People. Allison Markley says she felt her sister dying. Looks like the lady in red. James Markley, father of Tabitha Markley. Vanished from Fort Henry without a trace. The sentries did not see any sign of her. Okay, so this is probably a sister. Tabitha is probably her sister. Summary of Fort Hope. Okay. And yeah, it looks like I have to come back to those places. People. Clues. Bell. Scabbard. Shape. Alright, well, at this point in time, I'm going to take a break here. We explored Fort Hope area, at least part of it. We still have the stuff here in the north. So what I'll probably do is go that direction. There is that spider creature over there. I think there was probably one other creature over there. And then I'll probably head up this way, or maybe Actually, no, I'll go that way, then this way, then I can fast travel back here. And it looks like when we leave, we head off in that direction. Yeah. Anyway, at this point, I'd like to say thank you for joining me for this episode of Betrayer. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott for SB Gaming. And as always, have a good day.